Okay. So the opposite direction that the other two goblins attempted to run to.
Yes, you can roll an intelligence check on that.
Okay. Raw D20, so 18.
Raw intelligence. More than enough. They tactically retreated on the side that gave them the best opportunity to get away, as opposed to heading towards the destination.
Okay.
All right.
So, I'm gonna approach the group, kind of get everybody together, and so I've got the trail of the two goblins that took the blacksmith's daughter. What we're gonna do now is I'm gonna follow the trail, and you know I'm gonna be what you might call a sneaky beaky boy, and I'm gonna go and take the lead. I want you guys to kind of hang back a bit, not too far, you know.
Not to be is somebody rain. Hearing the crackling? Is that Dylan's mic? Owen. Oh, it's Owen.
Is it me?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. It sounds like someone's mic is shorting out, or they're coughing into it.
So yeah, I'll lead the way. I'll follow the trail. I want you guys to stay behind so you don't fuck up the trail and I can follow it properly. And possibly I might be able to get a drop on some goblins or come up on it easier.
Better?
Seems so.
Way better.
Sorry about that.
Okay, so now I would like to follow the trail stealthily as possible.
Can I detect evil on our bard?
You definitely can try. You only get to do it once a day, so you might not want to waste it on a bard.
He's pitch black.
That's a 13 on my stealth. And then would I get any, like, are there any about 3-5 for, like, since I'm tracking goblins?
You are +2 to all things goblin oriented.
Okay, so +5, 15 for my stealth on following the trail.
Okay.
And I would like to do that.
And ostensibly, we're falling behind at a slower pace. Or not a slower pace, but, you know, far enough.
I'd also like to be, like, aware of possibly any goblin traps that they might set up along the path, like, in their stead.
Okay. Do you guys see the little bit of green grass on the new map?
Yeah.
Okay, you come through the hills, and as you crest the hill, you can see what looks like a large bronze door in the hillside on the opposite side of the next hill. And if you guys pan out really, really far to the edge of your field of vision, you can see there are two goblins standing there guarding the door. I'm just going to run to the bathroom and grab another drink while you guys ponder your situation.
Okay. Grab a drink as well.
How do I move? How do I move the
vehicle? That was terrible.
Yeah, it hurt. There's some vape in me when that happened, and it's pulled out of my nose really hard.
What are you asking about?
I figured it out.
I'm back.
Alright.
I think I want to put on my big dick shoes, guys, and just charge these boys. Because reasonably, they live in a hill, and what are they going to do?
I am mostly out of spells, by the way.
Yeah, I was wondering, like, are cantrips the same in 5e, or are they actually spells?
They're spells.
So you can actually have a limited amount of, of level zeros?
Right. I see.
Yeah, so I have 3 left right now.
I could possibly just long range these boys, but, you know, if I shoot at them, they might just fucking walk in the door.
Yeah.
So.
They're gonna just, like, tell everybody.
Yeah.
But maybe we can give them gold and they'll go away.
I can speak goblin.
Not really how goblins work. I can tell you that because I'm an expert.
Oh, shit. You're right. Maybe we could do exactly that.
Maybe what we can do is go wide, go around, and come up the back side of the hill and drop down on top of them.
Yes. But
yeah, we can definitely try that.
Can we all do like perception checks to see the surrounding area?
Yeah, so I mean, something that you guys have been doing that you definitely can do is, like, if I say I want to do a perception check, like, you guys can definitely also say you want to do a perception check as long as it isn't metagame.
You right. Through this game, I've eaten a whole bag of Doritos.
When we come into, like, a new area, like, if I say I want to do a perception check first, that doesn't mean you guys can't make it fall. It's just, like, if you guys get better than me and that notices something, then, like, I can't metagame that what he tells you, you see, and then you have to relay that as information in character. Or we don't know it. Kind of like when the goblins ambushed us, like, if I had just darted off into the bushes without saying anything, like, in character, you guys just would have been like, what the fuck's his problem? Like, as you guys get fucked up by goblins.
Okay. I think we're all going to make perception checks of the area.
Okay. You may do that.
Do you roll a 20 on this? I don't remember. Don't
be... 18 for regular perception, and then 20 goblin... related.
Okay. Yeah, you can roll your modified roll, or you can just roll a d20 and tell me what the modifier is, or you can roll slash r d20 plus your mod.
Woohoo! Tell me what I see with this one.
I see the world.
Oh, shit. God damn it.
Okay, you guys perceive nothing. Dylan, you notice that there are goblin tracks that circle around this area.
On a quick side note, Dylan, you know how you're telling us that we should also do perception checks? I don't think we should ever bother. I mean, look at this.
So to expand on that, so like there's like tracks there. I'm just going to draw. So like there's tracks going like out that way, and tracks going out that way.
No, you cannot see that far away, but there are tracks going this way.
Okay.
Patrols.
Bingo.
Yeah.
Bum so, rush. I'm
gonna do I see any patrol? Like, I'm sorry. Can you tell me a little bit more about, like, are we on top of a hill and then it goes down?
Yes, you're on top of a hill. The area in between is a valley.
Yeah.
And then going about halfway up the other side of the hill, there is a large bronze door in the side of the hill. And there seems to be a little bit of a old path that leads up to it. And there are two goblins guarding the entryway.
Okay. And how far does the hill go that way? And then that way? Like?
The screen on both sides.
Okay. So like we can work our way around it and then come down on top.
No, you'd have to circle around a tremendous distance to get at it from the top.
Okay.
That's the 200 IQ play.
What time of day is it?
It is getting dark. It is late in the day. It was already dusk when you guys headed out, and it's been like an hour and a half since then.
Is there a time that goblins usually do their rituals that I would know?
At sunset.
Perfect.
Oh shit, dude.
Do I see the I'm assuming I can deduce that the tracks like kind of in front of us are from patrols.
You can assume whatever you want to assume.
Does anyone have a candle?
I believe that's what I assume.
No.
Somebody wanted to get a candle at the beginning, why didn't you?
Yeah, Owen.
I didn't want to ask Russell. He was already a quadriplegic.
Why was he a quadriplegic?
I'm going to gesture to like the kind of tracks in front of us and relay to the party that these are likely patrol tracks. So we probably can't hang around here for too long without being discovered. But I'm kind of at a loss of what to do right now. I can shoot them with my bow, but you know, what's stopping them from just going inside the door as soon as I shoot my arrow? I think you guys have any ideas, or
I'm with Owen.
I just want to walk forward down into this valley and see what they do.
All right. Well, it's before, as he's doing that, like, I would like to ready my bow and arrow, like, before he gets out into the open.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to ready my rapier, and I'm going to go with Owen.
Does okay. my light crossbow reach 105 feet?
I think the range on a light crossbow is, like, 80 feet.
Okay.
I'm in range, right?
I'm going to ready my sword and shield.
Light crossbow, range 80 feet. So beyond 80 feet, you're minus 2 to hit.
What kind of shield do I have?
A heavy steel shield.
Okay.
Okay, so you guys can move 6 squares at a time, 30 feet. So start moving to where you want to be, and we'll take it round by round from there.
So I'm assuming we're kind of at the crest of the hill?
Yep, you guys crest this hill, and you can see the goblins on the side of the next hill, and the valley is the kill zone. I mean, meaningless area.
I'm going to stay at the top of this hill with my bow and arrow ready.
So we're in a valley right now, right? Or we just came out of it?
The red lines are the valley, so you are down in the valley at this point.
All right, cool.
Okay, the goblins do not seem to notice you.
All right. Keep going, boys. Just keep going.
Big dick plays. Oops. I'm gonna be right here.
I don't know if it matters to you, but I'd like to actually mention that I'm not gonna tunnel vision on. Stay aware of my surroundings as best I can.
Just keep in mind, Mark, that your shield spell has expired at this point.
Yep. That's why they're in front of me.
All right, that takes care of our round, John.
Okay, I'm just going to roll another set of perception checks. Okay, they still fail to see you.
All right, now that we're closer, I'm going to do another perception.
Same.
17. Now that we're coming up.
Okay.
Near this hill.
For every 10 feet you are away from the target of what you're trying to perceive, you're minus 1, so you guys are making your perception checks at minus 4. What are you trying to perceive?
More so just the left and right, just to see if there's another patrol nearby.
I'm perceiving to my left.
I'll perceive to my right, I guess.
I'm not paying attention to anything but what my boys are doing.
Okay. You do not see any other goblins in the vicinity. Brayden, you are confident that there aren't any other goblins around. Owen, you are, like, looking over your shoulder with this weird feeling that there might be goblins around here somewhere.
Oop. Being a security guard, they have terrible patrols.
Get up here, Owen.
And as soon as I can see, like, if combat is going to start, I'd like to loose an arrow at the goblins.
Okay. Everyone can take their action for this third round, and then we will roll initiative, because when you're standing right in front of the goblin, you're very obvious.
Yes. Can I do swift action and then hit?
You can do a swift action, but I don't think there's any swift action you can do at this range, because all of your spells are 25 feet.
No, I mean, like, I'm 5 feet away for to hit him with the rapier.
Oh, sorry, I saw Mark measuring. I can't recognize everyone's voice. Yes, as a swift action, you can 5 foot up, but you can't do that until initiative.
Okay. So, can I take any preemptive attack where I'm at right now as Bardicky, or no?
No.
So, is it reasonable to assume that I see them running up, and I could probably lose an arrow before they get up to where they are?
You, as your action this round, you can fire an arrow if you want.
Okay, I'm gonna do that.
Are you doing anything, Mark?
I'd like to fire a crossbow at anyone I can see through them.
9.
Okay, they are not currently engaged in combat, so you don't suffer a penalty for hitting them. Just so you're aware, when you fire into combat, you suffer a minus four penalty if you don't have the feat precise shot.
Is that because I'm a certain distance away?
It's because you're not in the way at the moment. As soon as you engage, as soon as Braden and Bardicky move up and physically attack, they are now obstacles you have to shoot around.
Right.
Because we're in your line of sight.
Yeah.
Can I do Inspire Courage right now?
You can do it as your action, yeah.
Okay.
Your action after initiative, because you've already moved up.
After initiative, gotcha. Cool.
I have a question about daily things. So is it a new day just when it turns time, or does it have to be 24 hours?
For most purposes, sleeping for 8 hours is what makes it a new day. For religious reasons, for the cleric and the paladin, a new day is dawn or midnight, depending upon the religion. Anytime you can take 8 hours sleep and you can actually sleep, like you can't get up, adventure for an hour, and then take an 8 hour nap because you wouldn't physically be tired at that point. But as long as you get your...
Evil? I don't understand how Smite Evil works because I can't find out my sheet, but...
It's down at the bottom, but Smite Evil gives you your charisma bonus to hit and your level to damage. So it gives you +3 to hit and +1 to damage as a normal attack, and then you can hold that attack for one round per level if you happen to miss. This may not be the best time to use it.
Okay, I found Smite Evil. I just couldn't find it. But alright, good to know. Alright, so I can't do anything from here because...
Nope, you guys have taken your action this round, so did our two rangers roll their attacks?
Yeah, both bad.
Okay, then it's initiative.
Man, that's a 5. Alright.
You fucking suck.
Solid,
boys. I have to agree. You fucking suck.
You didn't click on your token.
You know what, boy? I have the highest kill count. I don't want to hear it. I've confirmed.
You have the highest what, Dylan?
Kill count.
Fair enough. I have the highest irrelevancy count.
I think you're tied with Owen. Actually,
no. Owen killed a man. I dealt true damage and health and healed one hit point, and that is all I did.
Wait, why am I the target of the competency right now then?
I realize you guys are not familiar with all of your abilities, but I was kind of surprised that you didn't cast sleep on the goblins in the first fight, and they would have been much easier to fight when they were laying on the ground unconscious.
Yeah, that probably would have helped.
We're isn't singing. Isn't that where the coup de grace comes in?
For yep.
Yeah.
Okay, Bardicky, you are up. What are you doing?
So Inspire Courage, what kind of action is that?
That is a standard action that does not provoke an attack of opportunity, so you can just start singing to get everyone excited. You can also play your musical instrument or do some other thing, but singing is the one that will allow you to fight simultaneously.
Okay, Owen, we're gonna stab some guys. Get ready for some blood and eyes.
That was actually pretty good.
And then, so I still have a swift and a movement.
Yep.
I feel invigorated.
And movement's below standard as far as like degrading down, right?
Yeah, your standard action is basically 3.1 seconds of your round, and then of there your 6 seconds. Yeah, yeah. Of your 6 second round.
Okay, and I have 3 cantrips left. What do I got? So I have Disrupt Undead, Cure Minor Runes, Rock Wrath. Probably want to save the cantrips for healing, so I won't do any more Rock Wrath because it doesn't do fuck all. Yeah, alright. I've just inspired you, Owen, and that's going to be my turn.
I didn't take it into account in the last fight, and if you want to switch out the spell, you can, Bardicky. But because Rock Wrath actually conjures a piece of rock and throws it, it would account as a physical attack as opposed to a magical attack. So if you want to swap that for like Acid Splash or electric jolt or something, you can do that afterwards. I didn't think about it until we were in play. I was like, oh, that might not be so great if that's your only attack option. There are times when you're going to want to use a physical attack versus a magical attack, so it has its pluses and its minuses.
I don't even worry you this deep in. I'll just hang on to it.
Yep, that's fine. Okay, so you're just going to stand your ground where you are?
Yeah, and there's not much else I can do.
Okay, I also didn't point this out to you earlier, just because it adds more math to the situation. But if you want to track it, if you don't take your standard action, you can add +4 to your initiative the next round. If you don't take your move action, you can add +2. And if you don't take your swift action, you can add +1. If
so
to your next initiative. So when you re-roll, if you have residual actions that you had saved, it gives you just a little bit of a perk the next round.
Can you repeat that? You cut out most of it.
If you don't take a standard action, you get a +2 on your next initiative. If you don't take a swift action, you get a position roll.
And same plus, for move?
Yeah. Move is +2, swift is +1, standard is +4. So you didn't take a move or a swift, so you'll be +3 on your next initiative.
Cool.
I have a question.
Shoot.
I have bonus feats, improved initiative. What does that do again?
Improved initiative gives you +4 to your initiative check. If you look in your initiative description, the little calculation there, there's a modifier that says II, and that is +4.
All right, so it's already...
Yeah, you'd be at -8 if you didn't have that.
I just wanted to make sure I was... Then we'll be benefiting from all my benefits.
Yes, very good choice.
All right, I guess it's goblins.
Goblins are up. The two goblins lunge forward at you.
And me?
At us.
No, at you.
Yeah.
Okay, Steven, the goblin attacks you with a 13 total. I'm assuming that's a miss. Bardicky with a 15 total, which is enough to hit.
Oh no, buddy.
Oh!
Goodbye.
That's gotta hurt. Max damage from a battle axe.
He's good though, he's got 1 HP.
I'm at 1 because I got -2 for the armor. Staying alive on that.
Okay.
No, bitch.
The goblins stand tall, and it is now Mark's turn.
Huh. Oh, on your turn, cast Cure Minor Wounds on me.
Eat a dick.
No! I need you last turn.
I know. Do you have that potion?
Yeah, I'll probably just drink that.
4, 5, 6. All right. Well... Sure, I'll shoot at the one on the left and -2.
-4.
I got a +2 from Dex.
Okay.
And yeah, of course.
Might be better off to run up and stab him with your vicious spear.
I guess, even though it's fuck it.
At this range, you could also use a zero level spell, but like I said, they're engaged in combat, so you'll also be -4.
So just to check, John, like, if I were to move to the right of the right goblin and Owen were to move to the left of the left goblin, would Dylan and Mark lose their, would they no longer have that -4 to hit?
No, it's any time you're engaged in combat. It's very static on the board, but if you were actually battling, you would be dancing around in your squares and just forming a physical barrier.
But yeah, so I'm saying if we physically moved, like, to the side, so we're dancing on the side of them.
No, it's just the way if you're engaged in combat, the physical act is moving around a lot, interchanging positions as you dance around. For the mechanics of the game, you're just in your square. Okay. So anytime you're engaged in melee combat, the person you're engaged with has cover provided by you. And vice versa. If their archers come out the door behind them, they'd be -4 to hit you.
Right. So what if, like, the criteria is basically just like you're in the way, but what if they were like on the other side of the goblin? Then no, I wouldn't have a -4.
No, it's the same. As long as you're engaged in combat, you're firing into combat, there's a chance you're going to hit your ally. The -4 represents not hitting your ally.
So what is the threshold between not being in combat and being in combat?
Being 5 feet away and not engaged. if you were standing beside each other, like if he was talking to the goblin and you wanted to start the combat by shooting him with an arrow, then that wouldn't be in combat.
So that was just something we ignored during the last fight?
Yeah, that's what I'm confused about.
Yes, it was. I just didn't want to throw too many things at you at once.
Okay, that's why I was confused. I wasn't understanding why it wasn't happening last fight, and I thought it was because we were on the other side. But now I'm good.
I also didn't want to see you die, everyone die in the first round of combat. The only person who ignores that is Dylan. I think I actually mentioned that if you fire into combat without precise shot, you take a -4. I just don't think I imposed it.
Okay.
Do I have precise shot?
Dylan has precise shot. I think he's the only archer in the party.
Oh, so... I was the only one that I needed it. So I can shoot from here and still...
Yeah, you don't suffer any penalty. You are skilled enough to shoot around them. If you're within 100 feet, you get +1 to hit and damage for your point blank shot, and then obviously you're +2 for goblins. You're absolutely amazing in this fight, except that you suck.
That is a problem.
Then your character.
And then how many feet is my voice?
Your voice goes 20 feet plus 10 feet per level, so it's 30 feet out. Anyone who's in 30 feet of you gets +1, whatever the bonus is.
So they get +1 to hit and +1 on the damage. So you're affected by that, Mark. Not that it mattered when you left, but if for future.
All right, so I believe it's my turn now.
Can I get a magical megaphone so I can sing to Dylan?
You can. I don't know how you would get that and how it would work, but... I'm sure it could be made. So, Dylan, you're up. You're not last. Imagine that.
By one. By a -1 point.
I'm going to take my movement and shoot an arrow, which I believe a 19 hits.
Easily.
Okay. And roll my damage. So that is...
which goblin are you attacking?
The one on the left. So, 4 damage.
Okay, just subtract it from his hit points. Just so you're aware, Bardicky has 1 hit point, and you're attacking the other goblin.
He doesn't care about me. Which is not surprising.
My reasoning on it was, I guess this kind of comes down to your DM style, is a lot of guys, like, if I'm making a ranged attack, and I would have rolled a 1 right there, like, some DMs would have made me hit Bardicky.
Yeah. So like, I see what you're saying, and you'd rather hit Steven than Bardicky.
Yeah.
Okay, just so you guys are aware, I don't do critical misses. The only disadvantage of a critical miss is that you fail miserably at what you're doing. I might give you a colorful description of how awful you are, but there's no secondary effect, because I don't find that fun.
I was actually hoping for the team kill.
With that in mind, can I retcon that? Because that's what I would have done.
Yep, no, that's fine. If you want to retcon it, you can swap your damage. That's why I was pointing it out, so that you'd have the opportunity to change it. As long as what you're doing isn't exploitive, like you're not making choices retroactively, I'm cool with it. We're just learning how to play, so I want you to learn all the tactics in the game so you know what you're doing.
Anything else still?
I am my turn.
Okay, Steven, you're up.
Give me life. Shine. Alrighty. I'm going to hit this boy right in front of Bardicky. So, I rolled a d20 to check that. Nah.
Woo!
Alright. Since that didn't work.
It's a good roll.
I'm a minor. Cure minor wounds on Bardicky. So do I just roll a 1d3, or do I have to check if I hit him?
I think you already cast both your spells, didn't you? I think you cast them on yourself. You cast your virtue and...
Oh, I casted one. Yeah.
Oh, do you only have 2? I thought you had 3.
No, he has one for his domain and one for his high wisdom.
Oh, shit.
All right. I don't think I can do anything else then.
Okay, well, you can save your other 2 actions if you want.
Yeah.
Get better initiative.
Do I get a spell slot? I mean, rangers don't have a spell set at level 1.
You have spells.
What is the criteria of high wisdom?
You have spells. They're listed on your character sheet.
Right, but on the chart, level 1 paladin ranger spell progression, I don't have any. I have 0, level 0 spell slots.
Yep, so for every audibility above 10, you get a zero level spell, and every even one, you get another level of a spell. So at plus 1, you get a first level spell. At plus 2, you get a second level spell. At plus 3, you get a third level spell, and so on up the chart.
So with a wisdom of 14,
you get one first level spell, one second level spell, and a zero level spell. At 15, you'll get 2 0 level spells.
Okay, so I got 1 1 1 basically.
Yes.
Cool.
Oh, awesome. Sorry, you have a 14? You should get 2, because you get one at 11 and one at 13. Yeah.
So I'm 2 1 1 on 0 1 2.
Yeah.
Cool.
What spells do you have, Dylan?
I've got prepared right now. I believe I have Cure Minor Wounds, Electric Troll, and Virtue for level zeros. I have a Cure Light Wounds on level 1.
You don't get first level spells until 4th level. That's why they're redded out.
Okay.
You still have to be the minimum caster level for it.
But my actual, like, my spell book is Virtue, bunch of Cure Wounds, Blade Ward, Create Water, Touch Restoration, Summon Holy Symbol, Lesser Stabilize, and Detect Magic.
Okay.
Lesser Stabilize might come in very handy soon.
I don't know what that does.
Stop someone from bleeding to death.
I'm pretty close.
Nah, you good.
Okay, so is everybody done now?
Yes. I am my turn. And I guess
All right. This initiative roll determines if I'm a dead boy or not.
Uh-oh.
This initiative roll, I get a plus 1 because...
I don't want to roll.
All right, so minus 5. Boys.
Whoa! Damn, dude.
Oh, since
I didn't click on my token!
No!
Does that just mean it's not a thing?
It's not a thing.
It's not a thing.
Shit!
Wait, since I didn't take my swift or movement action, what is my modifier?
Plus 3.
Plus
so
3.
Minus 1. So you have just a minus 1. Okay, I can do it again.
You have a minus 1, but you also have minus 5 for rolling a 1 on top of that.
That's me.
Oh, okay, is there more than one person that has a minus 1?
I have a minus 6.
I didn't take my movement or swift action.
But I didn't take my swift action, so I have a minus 5, which is how I got a 4 on my 1.
Okay, then. Goblins are up, so...
I clicked my token.
Yeah. This is why I like rolling initiative each round, because it can get really, really tense waiting to see what's going to happen and who goes first. Yeah. Okay, so... I'll attack Steven and then Bardicky.
It's great, because then I'm not at minus fucking 9 for the whole combat.
Goodbye, boys.
Yep. Okay, Steven, you take a battle axe to the head. For 6 points. Bardicky, you also take a battle axe to the head. For 8 points. Down goes the bard.
You only take 3 damage, Owen, just so you know.
Noted.
So change your HP, brother.
So do I actually put in the negative value?
Yeah, put in the negative value so everyone knows where you are. At negative 10, negative your constitution, or negative 1/4 your total hit points, whichever's highest, you are dead.
I'm at negative 4.
Bleeding out on the ground.
I'm relevant.
Hey, you took all the damage that Steven normally takes.
Well, unfortunately, I actually can't stabilize you because it's not on my prepared list. Unless, do I just get my whole prayer book?
No, you have to pick your spells in the morning.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, so I can't. I can cure minor wounds, but that's it.
Well, you should probably move up and do that. But in the meantime... it is Steven's turn.
Avenge me.
Okay. I guess I'm gonna just try and hit these boys. Hit the one in front of Bardicky.
Bang! That's a hit.
Alright. I roll 1d8.
Plus 2.
Plus 2.
Roll an 8.
+3.
No, it's +3, yeah, because I sang to you.
The 7.
Hey!
It's 10!
Do they have armor? Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead.
At like -1 dead or at 0?
No, he's at 0. He's actually, he's...
Oh, no, ten. It's 10 minus 1, so he takes 9.
And he's dead. That's good. These are all good things.
Except for the unconscious bard.
And I don't really have anything else I can do. Unless my... Can I turn Bardicky undead?
You lawful good paladin, turn someone into an undead zombie.
Okay, Bardicky, you can roll to stabilize. You have a 10% chance of stabilizing on your own.
Is there any modifiers to this roll?
Nope, it's a straight 10%.
So I just do a D...
D10, D100, D20. The bottom end is your success area.
So you can do a D10.
You do not stabilize, so you bleed for one more point of damage.
Whee!
Alright.
And then we're up to Mark.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 foot step, stab, flank.
Nice!
Which is...
The brave sorcerer charges into battle again.
+2 as a flank?
Yep, you're +2 for flanking.
And you're +1 for my song.
Let's hope.
Hey.
Hey.
And you have a +1 to damage from me.
Hey! He's hurting.
Hurting for
sure. Nice!
Dylan!
Really
kill it! Kill it!
I'm gonna have to kill it, because even if I heal you, you'd still be... Our best chance, really, without burning all of our spell slots, is the potion.
That's me. I do have... Yeah.
Good. Alright, I'm gonna take my movement up to the line. And loose another arrow. And that is a 11, 15, 17 with the flank.
Wow, that's a hit, then.
Thank God for modifiers, right, Dylan?
Yeah. And that's 6 damage.
That drops Yay! The second goblin.
Alright.
Alright. Easy, boys.
Who's cool. gonna try the heal check first, or is he gonna dump a potion in his face?
I'm gonna run up, and what do I have for skills here?
Whoever's got the highest skill, or highest heal check, should attempt to heal him first.
I've got a +4.
I have a +3.
Oh, give me one sec.
No, it'd be really awesome if you had a cleric.
Yeah.
Remember when I asked if you wanted to go ahead for me?
Oh, yeah. Oh, is this a... Braid? Oh. Oh, yeah, and today is the one day for, like, the next 6 weeks. I don't know if Brayden said in the group chat, but today's the one day every six... For, like, 6 weeks or so, he is on, and that Saturday is today.
No worries.
I figured every 6 weeks, one iffy day is not that bad.
Yeah, are we planning on running this game every week, or are we going to go bi-weekly?
I would prefer every 1 week, but that's not up to me. That is my vote.
Well, we obviously go with the lowest common denominator, so whoever doesn't want it is clearly not going to be there to play, so we won't be able to play. Yeah. That's another factor, is what are we going to do when we're shorthanded? Are we just going to call the game on days when we don't have the extra player, or do we want to go ahead in other situations for man? I find it less consistent and whatnot in a real campaign, but it's obviously up to you. It's however you guys want to run the game.
I think maybe it would depend on what's like something important, then, and like Buddy doesn't care, then well, if there's something super story important that we need everybody, then probably not. But like, if we're like kind of just coming out of downtime and we could either just not play or like we could just do something else for a session instead of like, you know what I mean?
Nope, that's like fair.
We can hear about an ogre out in the hills that needs to be taken care of or something like that.
Totally fair. Okay, so who's rolling the heal check?
I will.
Mine's at plus 3.
Yeah, I'm at 4.
Can I bloodily gurgly sing healing him?
No, you cannot do your healing him. Steven, you can assist if you want.
Yeah, I was about to ask that. So what is the advantage, like what's the advantage to that?
When you assist, the assisting player rolls their check, and for every 5 points of their check, they add plus 1 to your check. So if he rolls a 20 on his check, he makes your check plus 4 better.
Okay.
And as a full round action, it's a DC 10 to stabilize him and give him back 1 hit point. And for every 5 points above that, you heal 1 more point to a maximum of 5.
Okay.
So
we got an 18.
18 total?
18 total.
Okay. So he gets back 2 hit points from your heal check, and then you can move on from there.
So he gets 2 hit points back, and he, like, so 2 hit points from the minus 4, or he's at 0 and he's at plus 2?
No, he gets back 2 from the minus 4.
Okay. So
who just put me at 6?
So basically, so like we're like performing CPR almost, like we keep doing heal checks.
If you type in minus 2, it'll subtract 2 from the total.
So wait, I did it to the goblin shit.
So do we keep doing heal checks, John? Like, kind of
no, you can only do 1 heal check after that. They're patched up as good as it gets.
Okay. But they're not going to bleed out anymore. They're
no.
Just unconscious.
Also, you can only do a heal check if you haven't received magical healing since the last time you were wounded. And you obviously can't be healed more than your last wound from since magical healing. So if you took an arrow at the beginning of this for 1 point and your heal check is 3, you still only get that 1 point, even if you have more damage than that.
Right. So he's stable at minus 2. So at this point,
yes, he's stable at minus 2. Yeah, you could pour a potion down his throat, or yeah, if you've got healing spells, that's probably the best choice. Brayden, you can roll another stabilize check to wake up.
All right, I'm gonna throw cure minor wounds on him.
Nope. Okay.
I'm gonna throw cure minor wounds on him, and then probably tell whoever has the potions to give him a potion as well. So is cure minor wounds just 1d3?
Yep.
I have a majority of them.
So you're at 1.
Nice.
You did it. Good job.
Do I have to roll what perception check to see what kind of loot they have, or?
No, you can just say you're going to loot them. These goblins.
Loot these.
These goblins have the same loot: worthless leather armor, battle axe, and a potion, and they also have.
What kind of battle axe is it?
Just a normal battle axe. And 8 silver.
Using the potion.
Yeah, I mean, you're at 1 HP.
I get 8. It's plus, the potions are plus 5, right?
Yes.
I mean, like, I could use another cure minor wounds, but then I wouldn't have any spells. I'm not likely to get another 3.
It's good, I'm back at full.
Okay, can I... It's obviously we just made a bunch of commotion. Can I like make a perception check and possibly approach the door and like try and listen in?
Yep, you can do that. I'm just gonna run to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
What do you hear?
Just because I'm trying to figure out, because someone wants to do something tonight, but I'm actually happy to keep doing this. How long is everybody planning on playing? If we're planning on going for a long time, that's totally fine, and I'll want to do it.
I think the purpose of this is just like to do, it's like a one-shot campaign. Like, I'm pretty sure that once we like rescue the daughter, then like this one-shot campaign is over.
So
what if we accidentally kill her?
So I can't tell you how long it's going to take. I asked John and he said usually like 4 hours, but we're like like, we're asking a lot of questions, so it's probably going to be a little bit longer.
Okay, yeah, so the one more time, I'll let them know. Thank you.
Like, we'll probably be at least another 2 hours. Mark, you're quiet.
Yeah, what's up?
You just quiet?
Yeah, I mean, there's not much to say.
Fine, whatever.
I'm back. Sure. Unfortunately, I have to drink a shit ton or I lose my voice, so it has to come out somewhere.
It's all right. Yeah, so I mentioned I was taking a look around for that patrol that might be coming upon us.
Okay, roll your check.
And trying to listen to the door. 19, 21 for goblins.
You do not hear anything behind the door.
Okay. But, I mean, that doesn't give me a whole lot, because it's a pretty thick door, I assume.
Yes, it is a big bronze door.
Yeah. And I don't see any, like, patrols coming up behind us or anything like that.
Nope.
Cool.
Hello. Hey, I'm back.
All right. It's been confirmed there are no patrols coming. I can't hear anything through the door, but the door is also a big bronze door or iron door, so... Can I just quickly check the door for any like traps on it, anything like that?
Yep.
Want me reroll or use the same perception?
Use your perception.
Is there any way for me to heal without
10?
How many potions do we have? Do we know?
Two.
They each had a potion, didn't they?
Oh, they had a potion too.
Yes, these two goblins each had a potion. Did you want to try and identify those potions?
Oh, I did it.
Nice, another Match cure 20. Minor.
And not that time.
Well, didn't you have a modifier? Oh, yeah.
I did.
See if I can take a crack at it. Nope.
You got one more try. Wait, no, you don't.
No, there's only one potion left, so.
Yeah.
You should probably let the sorcerer go first, because he's got a lower DC, because he can cast Detect Magic.
Oh, yeah, you're right. But look how... This is the only time I can roll good. It's the only time I feel special.
Yeah.
I'm gonna kind of just take a look over his shoulder. I too am. I need a nat 20 to identify this. Yeah. Didn't get it.
So we got two cure minor wounds and two unidentified.
Yeah.
Do I really need the health?
No, we have three cure minor wounds and two unidentified. Because no, you drank one, right?
But yeah,
you also just identified one.
No, so we had a total of four.
Oh, yeah, no. You have a total of six, and you've drank two of them.
You're right. I'm sorry.
But you drank two.
Yeah, Owen drank one last game.
Okay. All right. My bad.
So
all
right. Two and two.
So
I also still have three. Or I'm sorry, I still have one more spell slot for my Chimera Wounds too.
I have 8 health. I could have 11.
I'm gonna look over to Owen. I'm not sure. I mean, it looks safe. You can open it. You're a beefy, you know? You're beefier than I am.
I'm gonna open the door.
Okay. There is a large knocker on the door you can use to pull on it. And when you pull on it, it kind of bows a little and then pops. I don't know if you guys have ever opened like a shipping container. When they're really tight, they kind of make a snap sound. And there's like a very audible like boom when the door releases.
Wait, if there's a knocker, why don't we just knock?
Yeah, you could do that.
We should just knock. Like, I want to knock on the door. Is that okay?
Yeah, I'm
it's sure. Fine with me.
Do I have to roll anything? See how hard I knock?
Nope. You just tell me how loud you want to knock, and I will accept your...
I try to push the knocker through the door four times to knock. As hard as possible.
Four
I
times.
Have 15 strength, if that matters.
I'm just going to take a step back.
Okay, so you bang on the door violently and let everyone inside know that you're coming.
Good.
Oh, and when you need a shout at them, wake up, motherfuckers. It's Judgment Day.
I grunt loudly through the door.
Oh, Jesus.
Maybe they'll think it's a troll or something.
Okay. A troll that knocks, opens the door, and then yells.
They might just think I'm trying to get in. I'm a stupid. Trolls are stupid.
I'm stupid.
Well, I was just going to make that connection. I was like, yeah, they probably will think you're a troll.
All right.
I guess now we just open it like we should have before.
I open it and it makes just as loud as a noise. All right.
We need a cleric for this type of bullshit. Jesus
Let's
Christ.
Go inside.
To open doors?
to announce to the whole fucking world that we're coming in.
Hey, can you start singing? let them know.
Yeah, I can.
All right,
I'll just... Oh, never mind.
You open the door, and you can see a hallway. It's 10 feet wide, nicely bricked. It's even lit with torches.
I look at Dylan.
It's a candle.
Zero chances there's traps here.
Yeah, I'm gonna look for traps.
Okay. Roll your perception check.
9.
I would also like to do a perception check of the general hallway.
Not
so much for traps.
It looks very much like a hallway.
Perfect.
I don't know. I don't think they have a trap for the main.
It looks good, boys. Go on in.
All right.
Look. It's a candle.
Oh, shit, dude. I need it. Can I take this candle off the wall?
You can take that torch off the wall if you want to carry a torch.
That looks a lot like a candle.
Also, I'm going to mention that I'm going to walk with like my longbow in hand. Like, I'm not going to stow it.
All right. I'm going to take this torch off the wall and carry it.
Okay. Are you carrying it in your shield hand or your sword hand?
My sword hand.
So what are you doing with your sword?
I'm putting my sword away.
Okay. Excellent choice. Okay, you take the torch and start down the hallway?
No one if you want, because the rapier is one-handed, and I don't have anything in my offhand, I can carry the torch.
I'm going to throw the torch at the first enemy I see.
Okay.
Fair enough.
That they catch on fire.
Okay. One, okay, two,
so you guys
three,
can take one
four,
movement,
five,
and
six.
We'll go from there.
Perception down this hallway. Yeah, to the right.
Did I just roll that?
Yeah.
How did I? Okay. Oh, is that lit? Let me light it.
There is not a tremendous amount of light in this tunnel. Obviously, you're standing beside a torch on the north, and there's a light source coming from further down the hall, and there's a small fire pit in the middle, but it's just embers at this point. But you can clearly see under the light that you're holding.
It bevels off to the left and right, though. Or up and down, I guess.
Can we get a Dylan up here to do a great perception check?
I mean, you guys could do it, too.
Yeah, but we did. You roll better perception check for traps.
We did a perception deal.
I guess I'll poke my head around the corner and take a look, see if I notice anything goblin fishy looking. That's a 20.
You find a box
for goblin open. For goblin related stuff, and 18 otherwise.
You find a box propped up by a stick with some candy under it.
Oh, yes! I get said candy.
Where'd Dylan go? Oh, shit.
Alright, so I'm gonna turn around and grab Steven by the arm and like slowly drag him, around me and then in front of me.
Oh, you see.
Oh, wait, okay, never mind. Hold on. I see somebody. Let's just get the setting first.
Also, future reference, you have better AC and hit points than the paladin.
I do not have -3 damage resist, though.
Okay, Dylan, you see two goblins hiding off to the side in the tunnel ahead.
All right. And so, like, they obviously they know we're coming because of the fucking...
Yeah, because you guys said, we're coming!
That cut out at the perfect time.
Yeah, it did.
John, are you back?
Yeah, I just glitch in and out, apparently. I think it's Discord's way of saying, shut up, dick. Because if I talk for too long, it cuts me off.
So, are these goblins, give me the setting, are these goblins, like, hiding behind, like a crate? Or...
No, they're just hiding in the corner. They're trying to stay out of the line of sight down the hallway.
Can Dylan tell us this?
Well, if he wants to. I don't know if he does.
Do they, better question, do they see me? Like, do I make eye contact with them? Like,
yes, they both see you.
Do they see, like, they see me seeing them?
Yes, they see you seeing them.
Okay. Wait, I just don't know. Fucking Jesus Christ. Alright, so I'm just gonna pull out an arrow and knock it on my bow, and hopefully, and then, like, kind of, like, two, make, like, a hand gesture, like, two, and then point to the other side. Actually, you know what? What the fuck? Why am I being stealthy? You know we're here. There's two goblins on the other side. We might have gotten the drop on them, otherwise, you fuck idiot.
Okay, roll initiative, Dylan. Everyone can roll initiative for the point when you're no longer flat-footed.
Ooh, nat 20. Yeah, brother.
Do I need to add -4 since I don't have my sword out?
Nope, you don't get an action this round because you're surprised.
But you always roll the -4 when you're using the sword.
Just because I have it.
Yeah.
So, do I get a shot off before combat starts?
Yes. You said you had your bow out and you had an arrow knock, so you can fire an arrow right away if you want.
Okay, I'm gonna shoot one on the top, and that is a I'm assuming that hits.
Okay, if you're on the north side of the tunnel, the north one will have cover, and if you're on the south side, the south one will have cover. So obviously, you're shooting the right one.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm shooting the top one. One that I can see better. And only a damage. That is 11 damage.
Wow, nice.
So I just fucking snipe this goblin and like pin him to...
See, this is why we can just bang on the door and say we're coming.
Wait, but 0 HP, he's still up, isn't he?
Yes, he's still standing. Just drop him to 0...
I thought you hit him for 11. Oh, -1. My bad.
Cool. And with me getting a nat 20 in initiative, do I go Mark or does Mark go simply because my negative mod is so bad?
Technically, Mark goes first, but Mark's action is to stop being surprised. And then Bardicky goes after you and he ceases being surprised, and then it's the goblin's action.
So I get another action here?
Because you... it's your initiative now, sorry. That was your bonus attack.
Okay, so I'm gonna hit that boy, I'm gonna take a step over, and I'm gonna shoot the other. So that's... 21.
Yep, that's a hit as well.
And that's 8. So he's at... 3 HP, so 0 and 3. Alright.
Those are some pretty beat-up goblins.
Fuck those goblins up. Alright, and in my turn. Actually...
Did someone change the goblin's name to Dablin?
I said
it wasn't me, but that's funny.
I thought it was
funny. Wasn't me either.
I said it in my turn, so I thought it.
Okay, so then it is the goblin's turn, and the goblin on the south will throw a javelin at you.
Sure. That'll hit.
Just that'll very once. Hit.
No, it's just this once.
So he hits you for D4 plus 1. So you take 4 points of damage from a javelin to the face, and the...
So I take 3 to my DR?
Yeah, and the other goblin will drink his potion.
Motherfucker. Should have killed him.
Yeah, you should have attacked the same one twice just so that he didn't get to drink his potion.
Yeah. See, I'm not used to goblins being this good.
Bang.
That's a D35.
D35? Aw, shit.
And he only rolled an 8. Aww.
Yeah, I'd say
take that, bitches.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck, I should have killed that goblin. Oh.
Yeah, you're the goblin expert.
Yeah,
come on. Yeah, I am the goblin expert.
Okay, then, Steven, you stop being surprised, and we are done. It's initiative again.
Alrighty.
I didn't take a swift action last turn, so minus 5.
Hey.
Hey, we switched around, and there's this god.
The world's fastest goblins.
Their leader gives them cocaine.
Okay, guys, on your turn, you can each roll a perception check. The goblins go first, so they will both throw their javelins at Dylan.
Sure.
Finally, Dylan's up front taking some real damage.
Both of those miss unless they have a modifier.
They are plus 5, so okay, two so still misses. You automatically miss on a 1, 2, or a 3, but the 14 is easily a hit. Hits you for 3 points, and then it is Bardicky's turn.
So much you're made of.
Bardicky, you can start by rolling a perception check.
15. Was that perceive? Am I still here?
Yeah.
Okay. John's still here?
Yep. Sorry. I can't. I use push to talk, and I can't talk while I'm manipulating stuff on the map because it screws up the map. So gotcha. I was showing you what you see. You can probably see the little green bar that popped up there in the edge of the token.
Yep. Awesome. The whole inspire thing, is that like a once a day?
Yeah, because you get to do it once per level, so you've used your bardic music for today.
Okay. If I'm right here, can I attack diagonally, or do I have to be right?
No, you can't attack around a corner. You have to have line of sight. So if you're around that corner, you have no option to attack him. And if he's around that corner for ranged weapons, he gets plus 4 to armor class for cover.
Okay. If that's the case, I will... What action is it to draw the short bow?
Short bow, drawing any weapon is a move action.
Okay.
You can draw a weapon as part of a move action if you have a base attack of 1. So only the warriors at first level. After first level, everyone can do it.
Okay. I'm going to draw the short bow, taking up my move action. And then with my standard action, I'm going to attack this goblin right meow.
Okay.
And that's just dex, right?
Yep. It's whatever your dex modifier is on a d20.
21.
Hey.
Nice, that's a hit.
And it's a d6.
A good hit, and you could kill him. Down he goes.
6! Woo!
Nice shot, brother.
Anytime, brother.
No, wait, how are we supposed to loot him?
Oh, sorry.
And then I won't take a swift action, and I'll save that for my initiative bonus on the next bout.
Okay. Mark, you're up.
Oh. I'm just moving past the people work.
You can walk through a friendly square with no penalty. If you want to walk up to the front, you can do that.
Yeah. I'm gonna fucking stab this guy.
You want to roll your perception check?
Oh, that's right. I'm gonna stab this guy.
Oblivious to the rest of the world.
That's a solid, plain D20, guys.
And nice, that's a hit! Fucking sorcerer is the best fighter in the party.
That only does one damage, though.
Still more than the paladin and, well, I guess that's pretty much it. The paladin's the only one who hasn't acted yet.
And I'm not gonna do much either way.
And that's me.
Yeah, well, you're the tank. You're supposed to stand up in the front and take all the damage.
I've felt that way.
Okay. So you're done, Mark? You're not taking a swift action?
No. I'm good. I'm good with you.
Okay.
Are you sure you don't want to take like a swift one back and then no one can move in front of you?
I'm still holding a torch.
That's true.
You'll just move up and go over here.
You're right.
But he'd go through a threatened square going to there. But are you done, Mark?
Well, then in that case, yeah, I'll just move back.
Okay. Then it is Steven's turn.
Alrighty.
Start by rolling your perception check.
Yeah, but we're not getting anywhere.
Yeah, that's good.
Alright, we've learned nothing. Except that. Will torch do damage if I throw it at somebody?
It'll do D3 fire damage if you hit them with it.
Alright. I'm gonna move up here.
If you throw a weapon, a ranged weapon, in a threatened square, you provoke an attack of opportunity.
Even if I move, even if I'm right next to him?
That's when you do it, is if you're in the threatened square, you're basically winding up to throw it, and he stabs you while you're doing that.
I gotcha. Can I just hit him with the torch?
You can beat him with the torch. Why would you want to do that instead of using your D8 weapon?
Fire.
Yeah, it's still going to do less damage than steel.
So, since I did my movement action, what would it be to draw my sword?
Well, you could draw your sword as part of your movement action. You just drop the torch as a free action.
Okay, I'll do that. Then I have to roll to hit him.
That's a hit. Yeah, it is. You're plus 3. 2 for strength, 1 for base attack.
Nice.
And then you're plus 2 to damage on top of that, so you do 9 points. Minus is 1 for damage reduction. So he's in pretty rough shape. And that leaves us at Dylan.
All right. So I'm going to take a couple steps up. Do you want me to make a perception check?
Yep, roll your perception check.
So that's a 24 for Goblin related.
Fucking keen eyes, dude.
Is that one right beside me? Perfect.
Yep. So you can decide before you come around that corner if you want to move into that threatened square. If you're firing a bow in a threatened square, you provoke an attack of opportunity.
Yes. I'd rather not. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot the first goblin that I shot initially.
Okay.
The dabbling.
Goblin taking 20 points of damage.
So that's a solid miss. And then off that, I'm going to use my swift action to cast Electric Jolt on Buddy down here, and I believe he dies regardless of the roll other than the attack roll, right?
I think so. He's at 1 point, isn't he?
Yeah.
Well, if you roll a 1,
he'll be at 0. Right. So I need to make an attack roll, right?
Yeah, you have to hit him first.
God damn it.
Well, you get bonuses to that. You're plus 2 for being a goblin, plus 1 for your base attack, and 3 for your thingy.
13, damn.
13 is his touch AC.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, he gets two for dex and one for size small.
Damn.
Excellent. He's at 0 hit points.
I've reduced two of these motherfuckers to 0.
For loving to kill goblins, you just can't finish the job.
I've done like 20 damage in fights. But I have no kill.
He loves killing the goblins. He doesn't actually like them when they're killed.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it.
Okay, so we're done. It's initiative.
Alright, so I have a plus one. Or actually, my short bow gives me a different initiative, though. Oh, actually, so quick questions. I have my short bow out right now. So as part of the initiative, if I'm planning to use the rapier, do I still have a -3 to my initiative because the short bow's out?
You whatever your standard action is, that's what your initiative is. So if it's your intention to attack with a rapier, then you use your rapier attack.
Okay, cool. So then I just have a +1 from not using my swift. Click on my dude before I forget. One.
Did I click on my dude or did I forget? Oof. I forgot. Fuck.
Half as effective.
Gonna learn your lesson soon.
Sooner or later. Okay, so the goblins are up first. So the goblin to the south will 5 foot out. Oh, he's still got one hit point?
No, he's I forgot to do it.
Yeah, he didn't modify it.
Okay. So he will 5 foot out, and then he will use his move action to also 5 foot. And that is all he can do this round. The goblin to the north will move down, and he will attack Steven. Oh, a brutal hit by the goblin.
That was really intense because he cut out.
Yeah.
So he's going to move silence and then... Oh!
I was just spanking it real quick.
Is he hitting Dylan or Steven?
He's hitting Steven.
No, why'd you do that?
Actually, that's a really good question because attacking Dylan would make a lot more sense. He doesn't have a weapon to defend himself, but they hate the paladin. So he hits you for 10 points.
Oh, I'm dead.
Yeah, one HP.
You're not down. Yeah, you're one.
It's okay. All I really want to do is hit somebody with my shield, but...
You can do a shield bash if you want. You're -4 for using your offhand, but it's all good.
Yeah.
Okay, so the other goblin... Oh, that could be bad. He will move up and also attack Steven.
Uh-oh.
No big deal, guys.
Spaghetti,
the paladin isn't going to kill me.
Oh, oh and down goes the paladin.
Yeah, but for how much?
7 points.
3.
-3.
Well, on the plus side, the tank tanked it. That makes it Bardicky's turn.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Sing me awake.
I can't get next to Steven without going in the attack range.
So for him to move into or through Mark Square, would he provoke an attack up? Or because Mark's there, he wouldn't?
He would provoke an attack of opportunity going through Mark Square, but Mark could 5 foot into Steven's square, and then you could move into Mark Square. Now that Steven's unconscious, he doesn't occupy space on the map.
Can you hold your entire turn in 3-5?
Yep, you can delay your action to any point you predetermine. But you go after that point. So if you say you're waiting until Steven goes or Dylan goes, then you go after that person.
Okay. I'm going to wait until Mark goes.
Okay. Steven, you can roll your stabilize.
Oh, yeah. This is a 1d10.
Yeah.
Yep.
You're good on a 1. That's not a 1, Owen.
You do not stabilize.
The fuck?
Yeah, let me just get up.
So you bleed for 1 point. And then Dylan, it's your go.
Take my swift action. Take a 5-step. Fuck's sakes. And miss with my bow. Big time. And I'm actually... So I still have my move action. Can I stow my... Actually, so if I plan on using my quarter staff next turn, then I wouldn't have my... I would just have to use my move action next turn to bring that out, right? Like half of it or something like that?
Yep, you can use your move action as... You can draw a weapon as part of a move action because you have base attack of one. Okay. But you are considered unarmed if you're wielding a missile weapon or no weapon. So if they move up and attack you, they're +2 to hit you. You can drop your bow as a free action and draw your quarterstaff as a move action if you want.
Right, I'm just trying to...
I'm gonna be moving up in front of you, Dylan.
Okay, so that, I'll just hold on to the bow.
Okay. Then is that your cue, Bardicky?
No.
You're waiting till after Mark. Okay, so Mark, you're up.
There is the zero health goblin who's probably going to heal. Just throwing that out there as another factor. Not saying you should attack him, but it's a thing.
You should almost certainly attack him.
Yeah. If I were to do my electric jolt, would that cause that boy in front of me to stab me?
No, because it's a swift action.
Right, swift. D20 plus... Ooh, let's go. Nope. Definitely missed that on that goblin down there. So now I'm gonna try and stab this one right in front of me. And miss.
Okay, Bardicky, you're up.
Yum. Should I use my last spell slot to rock wrath this last dude? That zero guy? Not the last dude, sorry. But the zero dude? Or should I save it for cure wounds on Steven?
You should almost definitely heal the paladin.
Yeah.
What the hell?
The flip side of that is... As long the paladin's not getting up in this fight because he's so badly wounded, you could use your rock wrath on the goblin and then just give the paladin potions after the fight.
Well, that's what I was thinking, but...
Is it a standard action to feed somebody a potion?
Yes. It's a move action to drink a potion, but a standard action to use it on someone else.
Alright, yeah. I'm a rock wrath. This dude.
No...
Sorry, bud. +2 to hit. Come on. Come on. Come on. Fuck you.
Damn, dude.
Wow, that's the unhittable goblin.
Alright, well... I guess I'll,
Roll initiative? Poke.
No, I have to poke the dude in front of me, so my standard. I've only done move and swift.
Come on, brother.
Alright. +1 to hit this boy. Yep.
Well, on the plus side, we can all roll new characters.
Yeah, there's that. Yeah. At least there's that.
You're right.
Jesus Christ, the fastest goblins in the world.
No.
We're rolling terribly. Oh,
fuck.
I have to roll initiative.
I actually think we're like 7 misses in a row in combat right now.
Yeah, that sounds about accurate. You didn't do anything this round.
No.
Steven died.
Nope, I lied.
Yeah, no, the goblins are not on a missing streak. The goblins have been hitting almost every time.
Go, boys. That's a 26.
That's the only shitty thing about level 1 is that sometimes, like, you just get fucked. Not even necessarily the encounter's hard, but all your modifiers are so low, you just get fucked by the dice.
Yep, that's the other thing about first level is it really brings out the character of your character because you have to make choices without any clue of how good you're going to be at it.
Yeah.
Okay, Mark, you are up first.
We're going to try this one more time with my last spell.
Just in case it got missed, you can use a move action to cast a swift spell as well. So if you wanted to cast more than one.
It's his last spell slot.
It's my last spell.
That's fair.
Yes! Hey.
Please.
Bang!
Three.
That doesn't matter. If you hit him, he goes down.
You're dead. My boy is dead.
Nice.
We can drink his potion that we're going to take.
And then the wild swing after the success. Come on. Yeah, no.
Okay, so the goblin sees you strike down his brother, and he lunges at you with his battle axe.
You just killed the
my brother.
Brother.
My brother? Brother.
You killed my brother.
Battle axe to the head, Mark.
Oh, brother, God. Man. You have no damage reduction either.
Brother.
Oh, you're
6
good.
Points.
First damage taken.
Yeah, and it turns out to be all of your hit points. Okay, well, just to make things extra squishy, the other goblin moves up and also attacks you.
Ah!
No, he does.
Critical!
Well, you're probably just outright dead. I think you are outright dead.
You are at... You take 10 points of damage.
Yeah, that's outright
that's
dead.
That's outright dead.
No, what's your constitution?
Mine's 12, but it's to be negative or negative 10, right? Because that's fine.
Oh wait, no, but you're at 1. You weren't at 0.
And so your death's door is your constitution modifier minus 10, or not your constitution modifier, your constitution score minus 10 or a quarter of your hit points, whichever is highest, and the highest one is
definitely
your 12. So you have 3 more hit points of bleeding on the ground to do.
And another attack.
Part of the bar is gone backwards.
First damage I've taken.
Nice. Suck shit get hit.
Okay, so 2 goblins left, 2 players left.
We got this, brother.
2 people. I don't think you've killed goblins all day.
Okay, Bardicky, you're up. I'm just gonna run to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
Oh, all right.
Have either of you gotten a confirmed kill?
Dylan's got 2. He has the most still.
I thought Dylan's only got people to 0.
In this current combat, but the last one he got the most.
Yeah, and I mean I did like 20 points of damage in this combat so far.
Yeah,
subtract 8 because that one fucker healed.
If you healed the dappling, I would have lived.
I've done it.
Hey, you hit him.
I did 1.
Oh.
Hey, you should sing. You should sing for me, brother.
I don't have any more sing juice.
Oh, God.
Level 1, man.
I'm going to take a step back, just FYI, so that...
Until I come back.
No.
Swift action.
No. If I take a step back, then for them to get to me, they got to go through an attack off for you.
I don't think they're going to bonk me. Either way, they're just going to hit him.
Yeah.
It depends. Like, it all depends on the gob. Like, it depends on how he plays it.
They're going to bonk me, bro.
There's only been 1 time where he just didn't bonk someone. It was when my good aura came off. That put me down to 1 health.
I'm going to try to appeal to the stupid goblin in them. See if I can get them. I got a plan.
Back.
Welcome back. I successfully hit and dealt 1 whole damage.
You go, girl.
It was nutty.
On the plus side, when he's reduced to 0 hit points, that 1 extra will kill him.
Yeah.
We're assuming a lot right now.
Okay, so after Bardicky is Steven, who's unconscious, so you can roll to stabilize?
Just so you're aware, I'm not taking a move very swift.
Okay.
Because I don't have anything to do with those right now.
It did not help.
I mean, I guess I could just bail on all of you.
Yeah, go back to the town.
You too, brother.
Go back to Russ.
Run away.
You're unwounded. Run for help.
Yeah, help.
Okay, John.
Yes.
Being a goblin expert connoisseur, is there anything that I would know that goblins absolutely hate?
Like candles.
Elves.
Elves?
Goblins hate elves. You mean something that'll scare them away?
No, no, no. Something to make them angry. Particularly me.
You can talk about their mother. You speak goblin, don't you?
I don't
know. Mark does.
I do speak goblin. I do speak goblin.
Tell him your mom gay.
Alright.
You can say goblin curses to him and get him enraged.
That's what I'm gonna do.
I'm gonna take up their attack.
Uno, dos, trois. And as I'm kind of backing up, I'm gonna tell this goblin. I don't know what I'm gonna tell him.
I'm gonna go fuck your mother in her ear.
Yeah.
That no. thing, goblin.
I'm gonna tell him his mother's not a nice lady and her apple pies are shit.
Oh shit.
Oh, those are fighting words.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna shoot an arrow at him. Just to, like, seal the deal. And that's 9, 13. Do I get a plus 1 because he's close range?
Yep.
So 14. I think.
Yep, you're 1 for your base attack, 3 for your dexterity, and then 1 for point blank and 2 for goblin. You only need a 7 to hit, and yet you still suck.
Whatever. I do 8 damage to him.
Nice!
And he's at 0.
None. At -1, right? Oh no.
And I want to reiterate that he hates me right now. And he's possibly very stupid because he's a goblin.
That's what he's I a dablin? Excuse me?
Yeah, he's a dablin.
He's a dablin, my bad. And, I guess on my turn.
This is the second time you've put him to 0.
I guess on my turn right there.
Oh yeah, he doesn't have a potion to drink. That's awful.
I'm gonna reiterate that this goblin really is not happy with me.
So he's not gonna run back and grab one of the potions off the two dead guys?
No, I want him to run through. I mean, I want him to run through and take an attack. Make him angry.
His mother doesn't make good pie.
Okay, so, yes, you guys are definitely not good at insults.
Hey, that's fine. What if his mother prides herself on the pie?
Most mothers do pride themselves on the pie.
That's what I'm saying.
My mom doesn't shut up about her pie. That's all I ever hear.
You guys still gotta roll your initiatives, even though you're dead.
No, I don't have to roll initiative. They can just take their existing one. I just making sure that we have new initiatives before I descend them.
Damn, I'm gonna need you to stop rolling 15 plus on. You just go ahead and do that for me. It'd be great.
Okay, cool. Okay, so the goblin pursues you down the hallway. Bardicky, awesome. You can take an attack of opportunity as he runs past you.
That's what I was looking for. Yay. Don't fuck this up.
Okay, so is it still just a standard plus one, or do I get another bonus because it's a...
No, it's just a standard plus one.
Okay. I fucked it up. He's moving too quick. They're fat. Dude, look at that goblin initiative. They're fucking quick little boys.
Oh my god, I'm gonna die! Shit. You might be alone. Oh no, we're good.
Okay.
Del, you want to know what happens if I end up alone?
He charges you, hits you with his axe, and then keels over from the strain of it.
Okay. Perfect.
If you take a standard action while you are at 0, you bleed out.
Oh. I see.
Good to know.
I would do it still.
Other goblin
attacks... Mark? scoring a mighty hit.
Mark or Braid or
Oh, Bardicky. Sorry, Bardicky.
Oh. Boys. No, you're good. You're still up.
I'm at two.
We got this, dude.
The party is utterly devastated. We got this.
Should I, No.
When was the last time? How many turns has it been since you didn't attack, Corby?
I hit one last turn. I just did one damage.
Oh, yeah. My bad.
Good job.
Fuck.
Yeah, my bad. I'm sorry, dude. I do.
Bardicky, you're up.
Do you have any bonuses to that, or is that just...
That is my bonuses.
Oh, perfect, dude. Perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm one short.
Dylan, you're up.
Wait. I'm going to take a swift action. I'm going to move. Just kidding. Yeah, no, I'm done.
All right. I'm going to stand. I'm going to put one foot on this goblin's head. Point at the other one.
Elevated. And
shoot him with an arrow. For four damage.
Nine.
And I'm in there.
There we go. Less than 15 for initiative.
Do you want me to bleed out?
Nah, don't worry about it.
Wait, can I try and stabilize?
Oh, boys. I've done it. It's happening. I'm going before the enemy.
Do I get a chance to try and stabilize or no?
You can definitely roll your stabilize if you want, but if you fail it, you take a point of damage. I was just giving you DM lenience and not letting you bleed more.
Damn it.
Corby, you're going to roll initiative?
Oh, you did?
Okay, so I go first. All right. I'm going to take another arrow, and I'm going to shoot that boy in the face, and that's a solid hit. And I'm going to roll that damage, and that's a solid 6 damage, so he's at 2 HP.
Nice.
I'm going to die.
And now, well, it's a contested thing, so is it whoever has higher dex?
Yep, Bardicky, you go first.
It's my time to shine, and I didn't shine at all.
Holy fuck, dude, you got to work on it.
Dude, I have a math. Hang on. I don't feel like doing math. Never mind.
He failed three. Oh,
wait, even time, wait, right? Wait. He's plus 5.
No, he's only plus 3. He misses you.
Oh, holy shit! I have a 30% chance to hit him.
You have more than 30%.
Wait, yeah, no, I'm doing my math wrong. Hang on.
You have like 35.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot the plus one. Dylan!
Man, I tried, bro. It only happens.
Dylan!
This is you. This is all you.
Dylan!
God damn it! You're not helping me at all.
I'm taking the hits, man.
You're not taking anything.
I'm taking the aggression, man.
Oh, you missed.
You get missed again. I've used up all my good rolls.
I just imagine this fight is just like a congregation of like a bunch of idiots just like flailing at each other like ineffectively.
And so it's your go.
All right, I'm gonna shoot this boy right in the face. That's a hit.
Yeah, of course you can fucking hit because you have like plus 27,000.
That's a kill.